Hello students, today we are going to begin a new chapter, chapter 18, Wildlife. So what is wildlife? India has a diversified relief and climate. Similarly, diversity is seen here in the wildlife. So different types of climate and reliefs are there. That is why different types of wildlife also can be seen in India. In the entire world, about 50 lakh species of wildlife are recorded. So in the world, so altogether 50 lakh species of wildlife are recorded. Among them, 81,251 species are found in India. So in India, 81,251 species are there. So this includes reptiles, mammals, fish and other insects. So altogether, reptiles are there, mammals are there, fish are there, then insects also including. Exploration continue to identify other animals found in different forests. India is at the 6th position among the diversity. So in the biodiversity, India is having the 6th position. India has less forest cover. Compared to that, its wildlife diversity is noticeable. Next paragraph will see that animal geographical region of India. Natural vegetation, vegetation means forest or the plants, the group of plants. The natural vegetation region have been devised on the basis of their characteristics. Similarly, a spatial distribution can be made for animals. So that depends on the vegetation that we can see the that type of animals also. The wildlife of India is divided into 9 zones. So the wildlife of India is divided as 9 zones. So we'll see that which are the 9 zones. So to the similarity of their characteristics and their existence. So how it is divided according to the characteristics and existence of the region. So these are as follow. The first one, Himalayan region. Second one, Ladakh and dry cold area. The third, forest region in lower Himalayas. Fourth, high lands without a forest cover in upper Himalayas. Fifth, northern plains. Sixth, desert of Rajasthan. Seventh, peninsular plateau. Eighth, sea coast. And last one, ninth, is Nilgiri hills. So these are the 9 zones of wildlife. Then biodiversity is studied according to this geographical region. The diversified wildlife of India. So different types of wildlife of India, we will see that. The vast alluvial plains of rivers, peninsular plateau, mountain region, swampy area. Swampy area means like a wet area, sea coast, dense rainforest, deciduous forest, coniferous forest in Himalaya and other higher region form a vast background for the habitation of wildlife. So for the wildlife habitation, these all the things are included. Rivers, peninsular plateau, mountain, sea coast, dense forest, then coniferous forest, see, these all are included. The animals are seen are Asian elephant in peninsular rainforest, one horned rhino in swampy Brahmaputra river, snow leopard in higher Himalayas, wild goats and musk deer in Jammu and Kashmir, wild buffalo, that is Indian bison, tiger in central India and West Bengal, then Dukhar, that wild ass in little Ran of Kutch, and flamingo in waterlogged greater Ran, presence of great India. So these are the some of the important animals, or some of the animals are in the staying, or they are, we can see in the particular region of particular climate. Presence of great Indian bustard in the grassland area is not noted again. In the waterlogged areas, migratory birds from cold region come down in the greater number. So in the migratory birds are they are from cold region and coming down to great number for the waterlogged areas. These include Siberian crane, pelican, Tibetan duck, conch, karkara, etc. So these are the some of the migratory birds then launch the place in a water area. Flying squirrels are seen in the dense forest of Western Ghats. Flying squirrels we can see in the dense forest area. The Nicobar dove is a rare bird seen in Nicobar. So Nicobar dove is seen in Nicobar Island. Rare species of corals are seen in the Gulf of Kutch and Lakshadweep Island. Along with mammals and many types of birds, notice should be taken of king cobra, snake, python, iguana, that is patlaco also. These are the some of the along with the mammals, we can see some of the types of birds also, that they these type of snakes. Along sea coast and other water bodies, various fishes, sea snake, dolphin, shark, dugong, that is sea cow, octopus, whale, etc. form a part of animal world. So this also we can see in the sea coast areas, the water body areas. Besides forest animals like fox, wolf, nilgai, deer, mangoose, rabbits, wild hog, hedgehog are seen in agricultural area. So these are the animals we can see in the agricultural area. Many birds such as nightingale, parrot, peacock, weaver bird, chimpanzee, pilak, vulture, kaba, dor bagla, etc. are also seen roaming in this area. So these are the some other birds we can see in the agricultural area. So next we'll see that the largest bird in India is crane. You can underline your textbook. Largest bird in India, that is crane. The next one, the smallest bird in India, that is fulsughano. Fulsughano. The next one, the largest butterfly, that is birdwing. The smallest butterfly, that is Siraj Jival. Siraj Jival. So these are the important thing. The largest bird is crane. The smallest bird is fulsughano. The largest butterfly is birdwing. Then smallest butterfly is Siraj Jival. So next we'll see that the wildlife and the need for conservation. Is it any need is there to conserve the wildlife? Yes. While going through the past, it becomes evident that there is a danger to the existence of the wildlife since the last decade. So the last decade we can see that some of the animals' life is in danger because they are not able to see in the after few years. Before 100 years, thousands of tigers were seen in India. So 100 years ago, the many tigers were there in India. As per the figures of 2014 given by Forest and Environment Ministry, the figures is 2226. So according to the report, according to the report 2014, the tigers the number was then 2226. Tiger have grown in the numbers, which is evident from the imprints of their food taken during the last few years. How they are taking this number of the tiger? Because of seeing their imprints. Then this is a good sign. Vulture are on the verge of becoming extinct due to eating the meat, which becomes polluted by diclofenac drug used in the treatment of sick milch cattle. So nowadays that a vulture's number also become very less. Then Asiatic cheetahs seen in the forest in the beginning of 20th century have become extinct from India. So nowadays Asiatic cheetahs also not able to see much. Once the Asiatic lions of Gir, which were seen even up to Middle East, are now restricted to Gir forest only. So Asiatic lions, we can see the Asiatic lions are we can see in the place of Gir forest. With due steps taken for their protection, now their number is 523, because they are giving, the government is giving all type of steps to conserve the animal. That is why now we can see the number around 523. Once cranes were seen in large number in Gujarat, but now their number is reduced. Before their large cranes were many in the Gujarat, nowadays very less. Wildlife is an inseparable part of the living organism, because wildlife is very important for the living organism. But the decrease in their numbers somewhere and during few years reduce the quality of environment. That is why the decrease in the number of the wild animals Nowadays, the quality of the environment also becoming reduced, or it becoming very bad condition, which is a matter of concern. Shyam Garud, that is eagle, a resident of mountain forest in Gujarat, is now rarely seen because Shyam Garud, that is a type of eagle, and they were living, or they were resident of the mountain forest. Chilotro, seen in the forest of Vijayanagar Taluka or Sabarkantha district, is also rarely seen today. It is obvious that endless human greed and the run for progress have made environment imbalance, which would bring adverse results. So that is why, because the human needs or the human greeds are not able to stop it. That is why the endless human greeds, the run for progress, it has made environment imbalance. So total environment balance is not there because of human greed. Then it would bring adverse result. Still there is time. If proper actions are not taken, then the next generation would see the wildlife only in the picture. Because nowadays we can see some of the animals in the zoo or the national park or somewhere. But the later on, if you are not taking proper care, proper protection for the animals, the next generation, how they can see? They will see these animals only in the picture. So next we'll see in the table that important national parks and sanctuaries of India. So this is very important for the map also. For example, they are asking that Kaziranga National Park. So you can locate in Assam, the state of Assam. You can locate that Kaziranga. So in the picture you see that the Kaziranga National Park. I'll show you how to locate. So here is the Assam. So you can underline Kaziranga here. So this is a Kaziranga National Park. Next we'll see that Thar Desert. So Thar Desert, where we can see, you have to see in the map. So Thar Desert is in Rajasthan. So you have to find out where is the Rajasthan and you have to locate there. Then in the Kaziranga National Park, we can see that is a sanctuary, rhino, wild buffalo, deer, these are. In the Thar Desert, that is in Rajasthan, desert wolf, desert cat, bustards. Then Kanha in Madhya Pradesh. So Kanha in Madhya Pradesh, so you can underline here. So this is a Kanha in Madhya Pradesh. Then tiger and antelope. Gir National Park, Gujarat. So here you can locate. So Gir National Park in Gujarat. Then Velavadar Kaliyar National Park. Velavadar Kaliyar National Park here. So you can locate. That is also in Gujarat. The blackbuck, wolf, peacock and all that. So in this way you have to underline the map. You have to locate the map. So next we'll see that Bandipur is in Karnataka. Then Dachigam, that is in Kashmir. Dachigam, see here. Then Corbett is where? In Himalayan foothills. So Corbett is here. So in this way you can locate the map. So this table is very important, you have to learn. Next we'll see that the dangers to wildlife. So which are the wildlife is in the dangers to wildlife. A question mark has been put against the existence of entire wildlife due to the human greed and development in recent times, because we don't know then how it will be the existence of the entire wildlife. Then because of human greed it is reducing. So on examining the reasons, it is understood that the wildlife has become unprotected as they have lost their natural habitat due to continuously decreasing the forest, because the humans are cutting or clearing the forest and making the what is in the habitat for the human beings. That is why the animals' habitat is losing. That is why their life also become in dangerous. Hunting carried out to get skin, and also how this danger animals' life is dangerous. Then next reason, hunting, hunting and carried out to get the skin. Skin is good, meat is good, teeth, hair, bones, and this all taking and this is also big problem for. Due to heavy grazing by domestic animals in the forest, herbivores are deprived of their food, which result in the decrease in their numbers. Because herbivores and carnivores. So herbivores means the animals which are eating the leaves or the grass. Then it will deprive the carnivores of getting their food. Then that is why for the carnivores, because if it is herbivorous animals are not there, then the carnivorous animals, how they will live? That is why their life also becoming deprived. So these carnivores reach human settlement because they need to eat something. That is why they are coming to human settlement where the human, the peoples are living. For what? In search of food and attack domestic animal. They are coming to the human settlement and they are attacking the domestic animals. As they approach human settlement, situation of conflict arises between wild animals and human beings. This conflict leads to the destruction of wildlife. That is why if they are coming to the human settlement when the where the peoples are living, so automatically the people will kill or the destruct the wildlife. Besides, the human activities in forest cause adverse effect on wild animals. So next we'll see that things to know. There is a sharp decrease in the number of domestic sparrow. Domestic sparrow, that number is very less. Then lion is the state animal and flamingo is the state bird of Gujarat. You can underline that lion is the state animal, then flamingo is the state bird of Gujarat. Then Asiatic lion, then Gudhar or wild ass and party lizard are found only in the Gujarat in India. Some type of animals. Wild buffalo, Indian bison, elephant, cheetah, large Indian squirrel, tiger, etc. have become extinct in Gujarat. Nowadays it is becoming very extinct. The desert sanctuary of Kutch is the largest among the sanctuaries in Gujarat. Desert sanctuary of Kutch is the largest among the sanctuaries in Kutch. Then Porbandar bird sanctuary is the smallest sanctuary in Gujarat. So you can underline that the largest sanctuary in Gujarat, that is what? Desert sanctuary of Kutch. Then the smallest sanctuary of Gujarat is in Porbandar bird sanctuary. Then due to the decrease in the forest area, the wild animals occasionally come with the human habitation. So already we said about, because when the forest area become less, then wild animals, they are coming to the human habitation. Human interference in areas of wild animals result into clashes with them. In such incidents, wild animals become victim of human range and lose their lives. That is why what happened? In such incidents, the wild animals become victims of human wrath and lose their lives. Because the humans are killing these animals when they are coming into the human settlement. In south and southeastern India, elephant coming in search for food create havoc in the agriculture field. So they are coming to the agricultural area for eating something. That is also creating some kind of problem. Incidents of injuring or killing man by leopards take place in Saurashtra and South Gujarat and by wolf in the forests of Northern Gujarat. So what is happened? Some of the incidents injuring and killing by men, which are by leopards, taken place in Saurashtra and South Gujarat by wolf in the forests of Northern Gujarat. A precaution is necessary to prevent such a disaster. That is why some of the precaution we have to take to prevent these kind of situations. Next we will see that remedies to conserve wildlife. A long-term planning is necessary to conserve and increase forest area. Some of the planning is needed to conserve the forest area. We shall have to be more dedicated to implement strong legal provision and the strict implementation for the conservation of forest areas and wildlife. So that is why some of the legal provision we have to give to implement this type of provision or this type of rules. Various social NGOs
should give this top priority and arrange the public awareness program. So NGOs has taken some of the awareness program. These problems should be included in the school syllabus and make the future citizen aware. That is why in our school syllabus also these wildlife protection awareness programs are given as a syllabus. Before implementing any developmental project, its portable probable effects on environment and living organisms should be examined. Cutting of large trees outside the forest area should be stopped. So cutting the trees, that should be stopped, because the hollow space with them, their branches are nesting place for the birds. So if you are cutting the trees, so that will be the trees will be shelter for the animals, and for the branches will be the shelter for the birds also. That is why we have to stop that one. Ponds, farm ponds and wetlands which are necessary for migratory birds and for those which are habited near any water body should be protected. So if it is any water body area like a ponds, a farm area, wetlands, so that are the areas we have to conserve. For what? For the birds. So birds, that migratory birds can come and settle there. Then an active action is urgently needed to reduce the pollution. To manage the forest fire and anticipatory planning should be made for patrolling and safety. So should not happen any type of forest fire. That is why some of the safety and protection patrolling should be given for the forest. Then steps taken to preserve the wildlife. So which are the steps have taken to preserve the wildlife? Since early times, laws has been framed in our country to protect the wildlife. Some of the laws are given to protect the wildlife. Laws were framed to protect wildlife in the time of great Mauryan king Ashoka. From the Mauryan king Ashoka, then it is started to protect the wildlife. Fundamental duties of citizen and directive principles in the constitution also included these things. So this is one of the fundamental duty, and also constitution also given. Constitution also given these laws. Parliament has passed a Wildlife Conservation Act according to the recommendation of Indian Wildlife Board. And that is why some of the act also passed in the Wildlife Conservation Act. In 2014, there were 503 sanctuaries, 102 national parks and 14 fire reserves. So you can underline your textbook in India. Then all together, then in the year of 2014, there are 503 sanctuaries, 102 national park and 14 bio reserves. Of these 22 sanctuaries, national park and one bio reserve zone happen in Gujarat. So in India there are 22 sanctuaries, 4 national park and 1 bio reserves we can see in Gujarat. Some protection schemes are planned for those species which are on verge of extinction. So to keep the, to conserve the wildlife, some of the plans, the schemes and plans are given. Let us know about some of these projects. So which are the project is given to conserve the animals, to protect the animals? The first one is the Project Tiger Project. This project was launched in the year of 1973 against hunting and decreasing number of tigers. So that is why then one of the project is given in the year of 1973. So against the hunting. Hunting is not allowed and decreasing the number of tigers also not allowed. So this was implemented for 9 reserved areas, under which now 48 areas are covered. Second one is Lion Project. There was a time when Asiatic lions were found up to Iran in Asia subcontinent. The subcontinent we can see some of the Asiatic lions. Due to hunting and the reduction of the forest area, these lions are now restricted to Gir forest of Saurashtra Peninsula. So because of reduction of forest area, the lions are restricted in the forest of Gir, that is in Saurashtra. Then at one stage their number had gone below 100. In 1972, a project was started in Gir to protect the Asiatic lion. As a result of this project and the timely taken step, there are now 523 lions according to the land census held in 2015. So in the year of 1972, the lions number was 100 only. But afterwards, some of the protection given for this type of lions. So according to the census of 2015, this number increased to 523. In addition to this, there are other projects also, major projects. Among them are Hangod project for the rare species of Baransingha deer in Kashmir. Then crocodile project for saline water crocodiles. Rhino project for the protection of Indian rhino and snow leopard project. So these are the some other projects are established for to conserve and protect the animals. Now we'll see the wildlife conservation is possible only if society and the government show firm determination to take steps in right direction. That is why for the wildlife conservation, some of the determination, some of the steps have taken to give the protection for this animal, along with the development, we shall have to be dedicated to confirm our motto of environment preservation. So environment preservation motto we have to confirm. Next we will see that one of the table, that national parks of Gujarat, how many national parks are there, then how many areas it has. The first we will see that a Gir National Park. So it is established in the year of 1975. Area 258.71 square kilometer. The district of Junagadh. Then lion, leopard, cheetal, hyena, antelope, chinkara, then crocodile. These are the major animals in Gir National Park. The second one is Black Buck National Park. So it is established in the year of 1976. Then 34.808 square kilometer. That is in the district Bhavnagar. So major animals are black buck, wolf, cantmore, then bustard. The fourth one is Vansda, that established in 1979. Then a square kilometer 23.99 square kilometer. This is the smallest national park. Then it is in the district of Navsari, leopard, hyena, cheetah, chausingha. These are the some of the animals. Then Marine National Park, it is established in the year of 1982. Then square kilometer 162.89 square kilometer. Then the district Gulf of Kutch, Jamnagar. Major animals are seahorse, corals, jellyfish, octopus, oyster, dolphin, dunghan. So these are the some of the major animals. So students, then today's class we were discussed about what are the diversified life of India. Then which are the steps we have to take to conserve the wildlife. Then important national park and sanctuaries. How that wildlife is become dangerous. Then remedies to conserve the wildlife and which are the steps have to take to nurture the wildlife. So thank you students. Thank you for listening to my class.